हेलो। सो वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू। वी विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट वन ऑफ अ वेरी डिफरेंट टॉपिक्स टुडे एंड दैट इज़ व्हाट आर द 10 मोस्ट सीवियर एनवायरमेंटल थ्रेट्स दैट आर नेक्स्ट जनरेशन हैज़ टू फेस। सो वी वुड बी टॉकिंग अबाउट 10 ऑफ दोज एनवायरमेंटल इशूज दैट आर वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू बी डिस्कस दिस टाइम। नाउ द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग बिफोर वी बिगिन विद दिस लेक्चर इज सिंस ऑल ऑफ यू आर पार्ट ऑफ फ्यूचर जनरेशंस टू कम, यू मस्ट हैव योर ओन आइडियाज एंड ओन सजेशंस एंड हाउ वी कैन प्रोटेक्ट आर एनवायरमेंट एंड we welcome all those suggestions to be published on our channel and our website. So all of you who have suggestions related to any of these 10 issues that are there, please send in to admin@examraise.com and definitely best of those would be rewarded from our side. The first in the series, the 10th most important environmental threat that we talk about is coral bleaching. Now, as we all know, we have numerous corals around. Some of the areas popularly known for it are the regions of Australia, the Great Barrier Reef. Then we have the regions of Maldives, Lakshadweep, commonly where we see coral bleaching. Now, corals are unique polyps which are colorful and therefore are one of the best environment for many of the marine and aquatic species to be there. Now, not only do they provide habitat to these species, they are also one of the places where a lot of tourism is seen. Now, what happens with rising temperature? With rising temperature, these corals start to bleach. That means they whiten. So all the color that is there with the corals gets lost. And in this process, if the temperature is constantly rising, they are no more able to regain their previous level. So sometimes what happens is if the temperature rises and then decreases again, the corals turn white and then they again regress to their previous colors. But if there has been a constant temperature spike that has been seen, this reversal of colors does not take place, and as a result there is permanent bleaching that occurs. Now this bleaching of the corals definitely harms the aquatic life around it. We see a lot of damage to the aquatic and the marine life there, and also ultimately the tourism get affected. So those are some of the important consequences of coral bleaching. Linked to the coral bleaching, there is another major important aspect that we discuss is, as we said, this is the habitat for most of the species. So what happens is, with the decline of the coral or the coral bleaching that is seen, the habitats gets lost, and therefore you have extinction of species that is seen. Now when we focus on extinction of species, aquatic areas, marine areas are some of the primary areas where this extinction occurs. But despite of that, we have also seen extinction of species even in the land areas. So if we talk about, let's say, Amazon rainforest, one of the classic examples of recent Amazon rainforest in South America, predominantly in the regions of Brazil, has witnessed severe forest fires that have been seen. Some of those have been man-induced because they require land for industrial development, for urbanization. The other has come out naturally. Whatever the case has been, it has damaged the species that used to be prevalent in those regions. And more interestingly, we have seen these viruses coming up as a result of this. A good example to cite is what happened with Nipah virus, how it originated is an interesting story. So what happened was, many of the areas where fruit bats were found, mainly in the regions of Indonesia, witnessed a rise in urbanization and clearing of the forest and the jungles. As a result, these bats had to move somewhere. And when they moved to a region where the poultry was predominantly seen, or animal rearing was seen. So artificial farms where animal rearing was seen, and when these bats got exposed with those poultry, the viruses from those bats moved to other organisms, and as a result you had more virulent forms of viruses that started to evolve. So definitely when we are deteriorating the environment for these species, many of them decay or die but those who survive have to modify themselves, and they are meant only for the forest area. They move to the area where human habitations are there, and when they interact with human areas or with the domestic species, we could say, the transfer of the viruses takes place, which is much, much more virulent for human survivals, we could say. And therefore, extinction of a species in one way harms not only the individual species, but also mankind at large. So, extinction, we could say, both in the marine area as well as the land area has been important. In the meanwhile, if you have any questions, any doubts, feel free to post those in the comment section. Now, the next important topic that we talk about is understanding the pollutions. Now, when we talk about the level of pollution, we need to understand how the rising pollution has affected the atmosphere. With more of urbanization, more of industries coming up, we have higher pollution. Also, with more of automobiles, what would happen is there is rising level of pollution in the atmosphere. Also, with industries, we have more of water pollution, noise pollution, so all kind of undesirable presence of substance on earth in any form would be considered as a pollutant. Now, this pollutant, if the level of pollutant rises, what would happen? This rising pollution would definitely be detrimental to the environment, and as a result, there would be higher levels of carbon dioxide emissions, higher level of sulfur emissions, nitrogen emissions. Now, these sulfur and nitrogen emissions can come down as acid rain further on earth, and this could be highly detrimental because it lowers the pH. Again, on the other side, rising levels of carbon in the atmosphere along with sulfur and nitrogen definitely leads to higher temperatures and global warming, which is another issue of concern. The next important topic that we talk about is deforestation. Now, whenever we talk about pollution, we focused on rising industries, more land being under infrastructure, more urbanization that occurs. But how would that occur? Our land resources are finite. So definitely, if there have been forests in certain areas, we need to cut those forests, and then only we can have a urban land area that could be established, or an industrial belt that could be established. And therefore, deforestation is a primary reason. But deforestation again harms individual. You might ask how, but the question is the answer is very, very simple. Because these plants are a storehouse for the oxygen, because they take in the carbon dioxide and give out oxygen through the process of photosynthesis, which we have already discussed in the issue where we have focused on how these changes have been witnessed. Now, Altaf has a question about the viruses and their spread. So, the idea is a lot of belt of agriculture or forest region that was seen was deforested. Deforestation was done, so the forest areas were cleared. Now, the organisms or the species that were living in those forest areas, many of them died, but those who survived have to find some other habitat. Now, as a result, they moved from these forested areas to other areas where they could find trees or a similar kind of habitat. So, a similar kind of environment was a region where poultry farms were there. So, around the poultry farms, you have lot of green cover that is seen. So, these bat species, for example, which moved from the cleared forest areas to the areas where animal rearing was done, and close to that, these fruit bats used to establish themselves. Now, when these fruit bats establish themselves in the proximity to other domestic animals who were domesticated there, there was exchange of viruses, and this was one of the primary reasons for the spread of viruses, or viruses becoming much more virulent, because these are coming from wild organisms, and these wild organisms are interacting with the domestic organisms, transferring them to the domestic organisms and from the domestic animals to human beings. So this is a kind of intermediary chain that occurs, and deforestation not only harms directly in the terms of the emission levels, the carbon dioxide emissions, or the levels of atmospheric emissions that are rising. But also because the habitat of the species are lost, there are certain species which are on the verge of extinction. Some of them are already extinct, and for others the habitat is lost, so they move to a region from where they were previously, that is the wild areas, to the domestic areas, and these diseases try to spread from one region to another. Okay, the next topic, I hope Altaf that's clear, the next topic is extreme weather events. Recently we have witnessed extreme forms of weather events. Sudden spurts in the monsoon phenomena. We have higher levels of flood warning, sudden flash floods that are seen not only in the urban areas but also in the coastal areas, extreme drought conditions in certain regions. Recently we discussed one of the topics, that is sudden stratospheric warming, how Arctic region has been one of the causes for the extreme weather events occurring in South India and the extreme rainfall occurring in South India. So there have been definitely extreme weather conditions because of climate change, and these extreme weather events have led to much more vulnerable atmosphere around us because the vegetation does not have predictability. Let's say if I'm sowing rice and I want certain temperature, if there is a sudden drought or a sudden flood, what would happen? The crop won't be able to sustain. So there would be acute food crisis that would be linked to extreme weather events. Also, there could be flooding in certain regions, but there could be drought in other regions, and this could result in water shortage, or even if there is surplus water, that water is not adequately distributed to the right region. So there have been definite issues regarding those. The next important topic that we talk about is sea level rise, how the sea levels have been rising. Now the idea is very simple. What's happening is we have huge ice masses which are called as glaciers. Most of the regions of Arctic, Antarctic and the Himalayan belt or any of the mountainous belts have these glaciers. Now with the rising temperature, what happens is these glaciers start to melt. When the glaciers are melting, the water level in the oceans, in the rivers would rise. This rising water level affects what? Affects the coastal area. The coastal area submerges, also affects the small island developing nation which we called as SIDS. Now these small island developing nations, good examples I would cite here are Kiribati, numerous islands of Micronesia, you have Vanuatu, Nauru as some of the common examples. Now what would happen with these small island developing nations? First of all, they are already developing, so they have a resource crunch. Now the next important thing is, with the water level rising, what would happen? Most of their economies are located on the coastal areas. Now, if the water level rises and the coastal areas start to drown, what would happen? They would have to move to a further higher location, or they would have to move from one nation to another nation. We have also seen numerous migrations related to rising levels of sea, and this is primarily attributed to rising temperatures. Also, we have seen, let's say in India, there are numerous cities, for example, Surat, Mumbai, which are expected to be underwater in couple of decades, and the reason is there would be high level of submergence because these are coastal areas. So we need to have a proper planning and resource maintenance for the coastal areas, and the coastal zone management becomes very important. So there should be alternatives that could be developed. Now Netherlands is one of the nations which is talking about floating homes. So that is one of the future ideas which could be laid down. So even if we are talking about suggestions on environment, these are some of the ideas and the concepts that could be brought about. The next important thing under environment that we often talk about is understanding the global warming, how the rising temperatures have been affecting the planet. Now when there has been global warming, that means the temperature of the earth overall rises. Now with this rising temperature, as we already discussed, there are certain crops which are which do not have a broad range of temperature adjustments. As a result, these crops would slowly and gradually vanish. On the other hand, we also have an important idea that we need to understand is we have to move towards crops which are higher temperature resistant or resilient, and we also need to have if we are going for modified crops, the GM crops, we need to focus on the crops that could be more temperature resilient. So those kind of vegetations would be the future. Artificial greenhouses could be created. So to combat global warming, definitely we need to understand what kind of future vegetation should be there, what could be the best vegetations that could be grown. Not only just this, we need to focus on the carbon footprints that are being released. Now, definitely through urbanization, industrialization, we are releasing a lot of carbon through higher use of automobiles, the traffic increase, we have seen higher levels of atmospheric pollution, and not only pollution, rising temperatures as well. Now, how this could be curbed? So what could be the greener fuels that could be used? How there could be carbon sequestration could be done as one of the ways in order to reduce the levels of rising temperature. The next important thing that we need to focus on is climate change. Now, one of the very good examples that we would talk about is from the Jayanagar region of 24 Parganas in West Bengal. Now, this is the region where you have significant vegetation for date palm. Recently, what has been witnessed because of climate change, the output that is being produced from these date plants have significant date palms have been significantly reducing. These date palms are known for its unique jaggery, which is known as Nolin Gur. Now this Nolin Gur or the Nolin jaggery that is there is prepared from the sap. It is believed that around 7 liters of sap is required to produce 1 kg of jaggery, and around one plant in one cut can lead to 50 to 60 liters of sap. And the most important thing is this sap has to be the cut has to be done in the afternoon, and the sap has to be collected late night after the dawn, and immediately it has to be processed to produce jaggery, otherwise it would ferment. Now the optimum temperature that these date palms could produce best result is we need to have understanding that this grows only at 14 degrees Celsius. Now, because of the climate change, we have witnessed significant rise in the temperature. This rise in the temperature leads to reduced sap collection and lower levels of sap that is being formed, and as a result the production of jaggery has been affected. Numerous households which were dependent on this occupation now are finding it difficult even for survival. So climate change has definitely impacted the life of common people, and this was just an example to help understand it. The next important thing that we need to focus on is the depleting natural resources, be it land, be it oceans. Let's talk about these two scenarios one by one. So what happened in ocean is we have seen extinction of species, as we have talked about previously. This extinction of species has led to decline in the aquatic species, and the fishermen who are going to search for the fishes turn out empty-handed, and this is what is known as an empty net syndrome, because they do not find fishes as one of their livelihoods that used to be. The next is a phenomena from land. What has happened with the climate change? As we talked about the example of Jayanagar in 24 Parganas, we have seen that the arable land has decreased, or the proportion of the output that is being generated is reducing, and this would significantly lead to food crisis, especially for the nations which are not self-sufficient in food grain production. So food crisis is acute. The arable land is significantly reducing. Why? We well know it, because of urbanization, because of industrialization, because of infrastructural development. We are clearing the land patches, and this has led to reduced arable land. Also, the proportions of wasteland have been rising. That has has again been one of the reasons for reducing the reasons behind the reduction in the arable land. So that is how we understand the depleting natural resources and how they significantly affect the atmosphere. The last and the most important thing for us as human beings is understanding how climate-related migration has led to numerous people turning to refugees. One of the reports has cited by 2040, the proportion of those who are moving because of climate change would significantly increase. And that is one of the reasons we need to understand that livelihood is being lost. People do not have their homes, the coastal areas are drowning, and they have to move to regions of higher altitude. And as a result, either within the same island, they would be moving to higher altitudes, or they would be moving to alternative places where they could find refuge. Under the international migration rules, climate refugee is not classified as one of the categories. So recently we have witnessed people from Kiribati were moving to the regions of New Zealand and Australia, and they were not accepted as refugees because climate refugees is not considered as one of the classifications that are there. So we need to understand that climate has played a very, very important role in turning people into refugees. Also, we had one of the recent studies in Bangladesh where a lot of the areas which was previously under the regions of land is now turned into a marshy area, and even the area where waterways were seen have turned into silting zones, and as a result there is no more water that could be seen there. So all the boats that are there or that were there are no more useful. So what these people have done is now they have created their shelter homes within the boats, and that region is a newly defined area where boat is a place where a people would dwell rather than move from one place to another, and within the boat they are trying to create new forms of livelihood. So that has been very, very important to understand. So climate and climate related displacements, climate related movements have been very, very important, and we need to understand that these problems would rise further with the extreme weather events that are seen. The small island developing nations have been witnessing extreme cyclones, extreme typhoons, and these have again affected the nearby and the surrounding regions. It is believed that mangroves is one of the good plants which can actually bind the soil and prevent any kind of coastal erosion that is there. But a mangrove plant takes years to grow, and by that time many of the mangroves themselves get damaged because of the typhoons and the cyclone. So these people who were on the coastal region are left with no other choice but to move either to higher altitude or to alternative place for survival. Even the food resources are getting scarce in these regions. So those are some of the important things that we have discussed in this lecture. Definitely we meet every Tuesdays and Saturdays at 6 p.m. We have our lectures coming every day at 11:30 in the morning Monday to Friday and 7:30 p.m. in the evening. So stay tuned for updates from our side. Definitely, as you have requested, many of the NCERT lectures are under development and many more would be coming soon. Let us know if you have any questions or any doubts, and as we mentioned, your suggestions are more than welcome to admin@examraise.com and would be published with your credentials on the channel. So looking forward for your early participation. Have a wonderful day ahead.